This is Ghostmaker, and you're watching Jousters Origins Series, Episode 3. In this mission, we take on the Stalinasians. The Stalinasians are picking a fight with their weaker neighbor, Alexandria. We're here to regain control of Alexandrian airspace and repel any attempted incursion by the Stalinasians. This is a milsim-style mission, so I'll let the briefing speak for itself. Enjoy the show.
Talk about a surprise.
Yeah, right? All right. Squadron, attention to briefing.
Captain Waters, are all men present and accounted for?
Aye, Skipper, all present and accounted for.
Very well. Then you men will remain at attention while I indulge in the best part of my job. Lieutenant Hogboy, step forward. Lieutenant Hogboy distinguished himself by an act of combat prowess during the defense of the rum distillery and naval ports. Lieutenant Hogboy destroyed 6 enemy vehicles and 2 enemy ships, including a corvette, while demonstrating courage under fire and providing leadership for his flight. For this act of courage, the Department of the Navy awards Lieutenant Hogboy the Navy Commendation Medal. Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Thank you, sir.
All right, congratulations.
Warrant Officer Nightstalker, step forward. Warrant Officer 3 Nightstalker distinguished himself by an act of valor during the defense of the rum distillery and naval ports. Warrant Officer 3 Nightstalker is credited with 3 aerial kills, including a cannon victory over an SU-33 and the destruction of an enemy cargo ship and corvette. Warrant Officer 3 Nightstalker's demonstration of skill, heart, and sheer combat effectiveness is a credit to his unit and to himself. For this act of courage, the Department of the Navy awards Warrant Officer 3 Nightstalker the Navy Air Medal, and I personally award you with a ghost of approval for your badass flying. Thank you for the good work, Warrant Officer.
Thank you, sir.
All hands will sound off Bravo Zulu on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Bravo Zulu!
Zulu!
All right. At ease, men, and please take your seats. Now, before Mr. B-Car tells you why we're here and Mr. Hogboy tells us what we're doing here, I want to talk about our last couple of sorties and what those have meant for us. Command has taken note of how good things happen when this group of pilots comes together. It's been whispered in my ear that this arrangement could become more frequent, maybe even permanent. I hope that sounds as good to you guys as it does to me. If we continue to do this well, I have a feeling this could turn into something really special. So consider yourselves under close scrutiny at all times, and please conduct yourselves to the highest standard in action. If we're lucky and we work hard, we can seize this opportunity together. Mr. B-Car, please proceed.
Thank you, sir. This is the situation, men. 2 weeks ago, Stalinasian energy giant Gazpro throttled back the fuel supply to Alexandria to a trickle, and then demanded 5 times the money per liter. This is the coldest winter in 15 years, and Alexandria is highly dependent on natural gas for heat, so naturally the international community condemned this as a dick move. After a week of negotiations which concluded in Alexandria not coming up with the money, Gazpro cut the fuel off completely. It was at this time that Truman changed course. You might recall missing our liberty in Spain. Higher-ups in Intel believed Stalinasia never wanted the money anyways, and that this was just a setup to put their much weaker neighbor on the back foot. Shortly after turning off the gas, Stalinasia and Gazpro demanded 10 times the market rate per liter and began a military buildup near Sochi Adler. Alexandria countered this move with a buildup of their own and began cap flights with old F-16s we sold them years ago. 4 days ago, Stalinasia started sending its own fighters up, and when 2 SU-27s crossed the border, the Alexandrian Air Force stood its ground with a single F-16 Alpha. The flankers shot down the Viper in the mountains with an R-73. Fortunately, the pilot ejected and was rescued, but not without serious injuries, mostly due to exposure. As if the situation wasn't bad enough, 2 days ago, Stalinasia saw fit to move 2 TU-22M3s to Nalshik, right on the border, barely 150 nautical miles from where we're sitting right now. That's a long-range supersonic bomber, and it's in our backyard. Just moving them there was enough for the Secretary of Defense to call for military action. But it gets even better, boys. Yesterday, satellite imagery shows fuel and ammunition vehicles parked next to the bombers barely 12 hours ago. SecNav made the call to the admirals this morning, and we're on for today. Cloud cover is significant this morning, so we don't have an up-to-the-minute picture of our targets, but but this intel is very good in my opinion. I don't expect any surprises. Razorback's orders are to remove the threat of strategic bombers and eliminate the possibility of an incursion into Alexandria. Well, we're playing this down to the wire because the bombers are gassed up and the enemy armor has been spotted at Suchi Adler. Mr. Hogboy over here has three targets to show us and a possible close air support sortie at Gudada should the need arise. Stalinasia has a lot of flankers patrolling the area, including over Alexandria. They have a total air dominance over the mountains. At least they're limited to Fox 2s, but so are we. With the clouds being as thick as they are, it'll be difficult to VID targets. SAM threats are minimal and not really covering our targets, so we'll mostly only need to worry about the flankers for today. But there are a lot of flankers, and I don't see any way to sneak in and out. We will be fighting for control of the skies today for sure. That's all I have, Skipper.
Thank you, Intel Officer. Mr. Hogboy, you have our attention.
All right, everybody. Frequencies for this mission. Broadcast is going to be 230 megahertz. AWACS is Overlord at 231. Marshall ATC is 232. Waypoint 1 is a TU-23M3 and magazine. Waypoint 2, train stops and scud site. Waypoint 3, fuel and ammo dump. And waypoint 4 is the close air support conflict zone. Sorry. Disposition, all naval aircraft will start from the fleet. Vipers will start from Batumi. Spares for both groups are at Sukumi and Kutaisi. All of the waypoints are programmed into your aircraft. Gudada has A-10s and AVB spares for both, and aircraft at Gudada have one programmed waypoint in the conflict zone. From Batumi or the fleet, it's about 160 nautical miles to 170 to any of the three waypoints, for a total round-trip distance of about 320 nautical miles. In a fuel emergency, a pilot can land at any blue base, but only Batumi and Gudada have SAM coverage. A landing elsewhere may leave you exposed to red air. The mission profile is for a return to Batumi or the fleet, a distance easily covered in the F-18 with a single drop tank and full loadout. Flights. Beowulf, Mako, and Casper can handle waypoints 1 through 3 equally well. If any pilots fly in Spartan, it is recommended they buddy with Hornets from Casper. Mixed groups should take on the call sign of the dominant airframe. If one AVAB joins two F-18s from Casper, that AV-8 will become Casper 3. Flight leaders and CO will determine what flight is handling what waypoint target on that day. Waypoint 1. Targets are two TU-22M3 bombers and the ammo magazine. Both are difficult to spot with today's reduced visibility.
Mr. Hogboy, while we're here, I'm guessing this is Waters and Dark Helmet. Is that correct, men?
Affirm.
Correct.
Okay, you guys want to go under Beowulf or Casper? How about we go under, you guys go under Beowulf, because the other flight's going to be Casper. So you guys go under Beowulf.
Copy.
Okay, please continue, Mr. Hogboy.
Thank you. Waypoint 2, the three Scud launchers are the primary target. This is site is defended by an SA-6 and possible gun emplacements and man pads. Secondary targets are the small building and fuel tank. Tertiary targets are everything else. I believe that Mako Flight will be leading the assault against this waypoint.
And you guys have your game plan together in terms of loadout?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Waypoint 3, the primary targets are the magazine and fuel tanks. All other vehicles and materials are considered secondary targets. The site is defended by gun emplacement and possible man pads and small arms fire. The site is a fuel and ammo dump for Red Armor. It is very likely to have active MBT and APC.
That's going to be B-Car Night Stalker. Gentlemen, what I see here is quite a few tanks parked, and given that the cloud deck is low, you may have trouble hitting them from far enough away. So just remember, you don't have to destroy every piece of armor down there if you find armor down there, but you do have to pick off these fuel tanks and this magazine. Everything else is kind of icing on the cake, but I would be cautious about running in with, say, guns, where there's four or five armored vehicles, that's a lot of ground fire coming back at you.
Understood, sir.
Copy.
Waypoint 4 is the cast zone. Stalinasian tanks and artillery have been spotted at Sochi Adler with an expected push towards Aladzi. Alexandria ground forces are greatly inferior in capability and can only hope to slow the Stalinasians down a little. Blowtorch A-10 C-2s and Grimlock AVABs will be called upon to deal with the problem if the Stalinasians decide to make an incursion. With a low cloud space, spotting will be difficult. Be mindful of red casts. Aircraft from Sochi Adler, we don't have good intel on what's in those hangars.
Okay, Nomad, you are Blowtorch, and up to the minute here, I have it on good authority that those tanks are rolling from Sochi and possible artillery as well. So you're definitely going to be in action. You're coming out of Gadada, and you can see it's about, I'd say, 17 miles to where blue units are forward deployed. We've got a small army here and an even smaller one there. And they are outgunned substantially by Stalinasians. So I'm not sure where along this road that those two forces are going to run into each other, but it's going to be your job to basically patrol this and look for red tanks.
Copy that.
I will be above you in an F-18 just in case any flankers decide to come after you. And I think I'll bring a couple of Mavericks too so that I can back you up. But really, compared to your 810, my Hornet's going to be a sideshow for the air to ground. So I'm really just there to pack heaters and back you up.
Sounds good.
So besides the unimpressive SA-6 at Waypoint 2, SA-2 Fansong radars have been detected at Novorossiysk, Maykop, and Beslan. These Fansongs are well away from the target areas and shouldn't be a factor in achieving our objective. Still be careful you do not get lured over top of one. For the air threats, we've got SU-27 flankers flying cap on both sides of the border. They have total air dominance over Alexandria. That will change today, fellas. There is little chance of avoiding detection. You will have to fight to reach your targets. That said, switching your radar on and off can be used to draw aggro. A QRF launch is expected. Flankers are loaded out with short-range Fox 2s.
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Hogboy. Guys, we walk in 10 minutes. Beowulf, confirm if you are ready to take off.
Beowulf, one ready. Two.
Casper, confirm if you are ready for takeoff.
Casper's ready.
Mako flight, how are you feeling about it?
Mako flight is in the pipe, 5x5.
Roger, here comes the takeoff cue. Good luck and good hunting.
Make a one rolling.
Bill with one rolling.
Bandits on radar. Blowtorch indirect fire spotted on the Southern Army. Blowtorch, keep your angels low. I don't want a flanker coming down to get you.
Copy that. Break. Additional hostile artillery spotted north of the position.
Blowtorch 1, break for the south. You've got a flanker coming after you. Head for Gudetta. I'm on my way, Blowtorch, but I'm 88 miles away.
Bill is burning.
Copy, Beowulf. Torch, I've seen an aircraft very near you. It must be an SU-25.
Copy and switching. Are you by any chance in the area?
24 miles, engaging. Do you have a tally? He's got to be real close.
I see him.
Fox 2. He's hit bad, Blowtorch, but he's still flying. Send it.
Casper flight has two good splashes.
Altitude.
He punched out Blowtorch. I got him.
Copy. Stand by. AAA. You taking AAA?
Copy, Blowtorch. I'm safe. I'm gonna gain altitude and keep cover.
Copy.
Ghost Maker's got a band at 19 miles. Box 2. Splash.
Good job, Ghostmaker.
Ghostmaker ray gun. Engaging bandit 10 miles.
Ghostmaker, do you need any help?
Negative. Box 2. Splash bandit.
Nice shot, Ghost.
Ghostmaker Winchester. Can you RTB?
Negative engine is dead. Yeah, dual engine failure. Just find a nice road, hopefully.
Jet your weapons, blowtorch. Get clean. Are you seeing these light poles? Oh boy. Guys, I'm not sure Blowtorch survived that landing. Good hits, Mako. Good hits on vehicles.
Copy that. Mako 1 is flowing out and will turn into to re-engage. Make a one rifle. Make a one rifle. Make a one is trying to engage Bandit.
Stand by, I'm landing.
Shit, he's on my six. Mega one turning in to engage.
Bill of flight engaging airfield facilities.
With an SU-27.
Engaging I think I might have shacked something.
Mako 1, primary targets remain.
Thank you.
gets the primary target destroyed, Casper. Still that fuel tank remaining if you can get a tally on it.
Yep, copy.
Copy that, Casper 1. That is mission status complete. Good work.
Hooray! Casper 1, head to home.
Outstanding.
You line up right. You're on glide slope. You lined up a little left.
Well, there you have it, folks. We took on the Stalinasians and came out on top. If you'd like to play with the Jousters, just search Jousters in the DCS World Open Beta multiplayer browser. And there's links to our social stuff in the doobly-doo down below. Nice. Tune in next time for Episode 4, the exciting conclusion to the Origins series. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.